I'm well known for my work about economic power, especially the Table of Power series on boardrooms of the largest multinationals. And I was friends with somebody who worked at Fortune magazine in Japan. And she told me, if you want to know something more about, you know, Japanese culture and the industrial world in Japan, you need to visit a car show. And that's what I did in 2000. I visited the car show in Tokyo. And I don't own a car, I don't know much about cars, and it opened a world to me. It's quite amazing. So that's basically how it started. There was Volkswagen, the big German brand. They had this beautiful blonde lady, tall lady, that looked like a ballet dancer. And there was the brand Jeep was showing a woman who was, you know, barely dressed and very sexy. And she depicted kind of a fantasy for a Japanese customer that was completely different. And then I thought, wow, this would be amazing on a global scale to see how a Volkswagen girl looks like in New York, how she looks like in the car show in Frankfurt, in Tokyo, Shanghai, etc. And then I envisioned this whole global project about these car girls. The projection, you know, the complexity about the project would be best for used in an installation format. And then we also commissioned a sound artist to create a body of work that really kind of belongs to, or that is part of it.
C'est un aspect qui est assez méconnu de notre fonction. On reconnaît très volontiers l'aspect commercial de la fonction d'hôtesse et de steward qui représente tout ce qui est service et confort du passager. Et il y a un côté qui est un petit peu plus obscur dont le passager ne se rend pas tout à fait compte.
There are about 160 photographs. And then we pick out one particular category, and then it's kind of pure at random. Like some of them I have a preference for, I like them a lot, and others, you know, they're kind of, it's also a computer system that sort of picks these images. So you have different days at the car show. So first of all, you have the press days. So there are very few people coming, and that was in the end the best day to photograph, because you know, when you go on a regular day, there are so many male, you know, photographers. They really want to photograph these girls, especially in Tokyo and in Shanghai. It's totally crazy. You have to kind of push and push. And I didn't talk a lot with them. I just photographed them. But some of them, they recognized me. Said, "Hey, you were also in New York. I saw, you know." And when I was in Detroit, and they kind of started to follow me, and they saw that I was photographing them. It was really nice.
Encore un petit peu de café.
This is pure nature at its best, you know. You have the car, you have and the girls, and it's a perfect combination. They really belong together in a sense that it goes to a very kind of, you know, core of a form of attraction. And so because these guys, especially, you know, if you look at certain cars, brands like Ferrari or Lamborghini, and you have these car girls, they're touching the car, you know, this the female hand touching the hard body of the car, which is a very masculine kind of thing. And it really provokes, you know, something inside guys that are looking at it, and they think, if I could have this car, maybe I could also have this type of girl. And there's a whole sociological way of thinking behind it that I think is very pure, and I think it's very interesting. I don't really look at it as a feminist, or, you know, that's really not of interest to me.